Greetings, technicians and my good people of the PCL. I'm having some internet issues for the past few days. I apologize in advance if this video goes up slightly later than usual. Time sure flies by. Here we are at the end of week 6, over the half point of season 4 already. I hope everyone is having fun. Without further ado, let's hop right into the video. This video is brought to you by Sam's Delicious Garlic Bread. I totally didn't miss this ad. I mean, just look at the brilliant no bulk investment shaman set from Seattle Supersonics against the Red Dead Rowlets in Week 5's battle. This totally not copied off Smogon set allowed the Supersonics to simply click buttons and attacks and subs to claim all 6 kills against the Rowlets. I wonder who made this video. He has absolutely no taste. It definitely deserves the number 1 spot for this week's top play in my opinion. Excuse me. So for number 5 spot, we have Langshui Luxray against the Kansas City Kingdras in their week 6 matchup. After losing the lead matchup, the Luxrays will be able to save Valkyrie the Victini by pivoting into their Gastrodon, making the Kingdras thinking that the Victini may not have the necessary coverage for the opposing Rotom Wash, and the Luxrays will be able to pick up the 2-hit KO on the Rotom Wash with the Blue Flare into an Energy Ball. Later on, the Life Orb boost was definitely crucial in being able to achieve such 2-hit KO on the Rotom. Victini not only have the coverage for the entirety of Kingdra's team, but FaZe's execution in this game was great. Just be able to weaken the Kingdra's to put everything in range of Victini's attacks. Granted, there might have been some luck involved throughout the game, but there is definitely no deny in a standard Victini set played at its finest. At number 4 spot, we have the Week 5 game between Winnipeg War Turtles and the Monster Mimikyus. In this game, the War Turtles brought Doggo the Ante safely against the opposing Alakazam, forced the Mimikyus to retreat the Alakazam in fear of the E-Speed, then Toast proceed to beat down the opposing Kamo-O with a combination of Sacred Fire and Iron Head. Granted, there was some hacks involved and whatnot, but the burn on the Kamo-O was enough to cripple it effectively. After knocking out the Kamo-O, then Toast busted out the Natural Gift Electric with the Wacom Berry against the opposing Mantine. Picking up the surprise KO on one of the main switches the Mimikyu had for the Mamoswine, this allowed the momentum of the game to swing hugely in favor of the War Turtles, allow the Tailwind alongside of Mamoswine to seal the game later on. A well-deserved number 4 spot of the War Turtles for this week. At number 3 spot, we have Mirka the Braviary from the Week 6 game between Victoria, Victini, and Dragon's Den. After Mudkip Boy made an offensive switch into his Braviary against the opposing Skuntank, forcing it out with a Brave Bird. As the Dragon's Den goes into their Gyarados, popping the Adrenaline Orb on the Braviary with the Intimidate, allowing the Defiant to trigger to let the Braviary sit at +1/+1 from both sides. Due to the boost the Braviary had, and it was being able to 2-hit KO the Mega Gyarados upon switching, and then proceed to set up on the incoming Miltank with bulk ups, and then pick up 2 more KOs thereafter. This sets the Victinis extremely ahead, putting them in a comfortable position, allowing them to set up their Mega Latias to close out the match later on. The Adrenaline Orb on the Braviary alongside of the Defiant ability makes it such a potent threat in this particular matchup against the Mega Gyarados. This set was proven to shine by the Mudkip Boy. Definitely a well done prep from his end. For the number 2 spot, we have the Week 6 battle between the Home Park Hunchcrows and the Colorado Avalogs. The Hunchcrows managed to set up rocks right away with Mesprit early game, then continue to apply the pressure by double into their Charizard Y on the paralyzed Amoongus. Then proceed to get a Dragon Dance, predicting the switch out of the opposing Amoongus, knocking out the incoming Delphox with a +1 Earthquake, and proceed to knock out the Aerodactyl with a Thunder Punch. The rocks damage was crucial in this case. Playing off an overprediction coming from the Avalogs and their Scarf Raikou, the physical Charizard Y was being able to pick up one more KO with the sun-boosted plus one Flare Blitz, knocking out the Among Us. The surprise factor definitely played a big role in Georgia's play this week. This was not typically something you will see on standard ladder play. George and the Hunchcrows definitely demonstrated the beauty of Draft League this week. For the number one spot this week's analysis, we have Tumor the Pukumuku in the week 5 battle between Onyx Rayquazas and Jolteon Jolteon. After playing off a spin block with the Mimikyu against the opposing Serena, the Rayquaza managed to remove one of the biggest checks the Jolteon had for the Pukumuku, allowing the Pukumuku to beat the Celesteela in a 1v1 matchup with Spite as it does go through the substitute, as the Jolteon decided to stay in with Celesteela despite not being blocked behind a sub, allowing the Rayquaza to almost get rid of all of its PP with Pukumuku. After a series of turns, the Jolteon finally made a switch into the Araquanid, but little do they know, not only the Pukumuku had to recover, but they also had to rest for the incoming Toxic. By the time the Jolteon found out they had nothing left for this little tumor, it was a bit too late. A fine play coming from the Rayquazas this week after a successful spin block and the slowly wearing down the Jolteon with the combination of Hazards and Steph Pukumuku. Also, I do truly spite this set, but hey, whatever works, right? If it doesn't work, then just keep on bringing it until it works. It's not like he has been bringing the same sets over and over again for a couple weeks or anything, right? Hope you guys enjoyed the video and make sure to comment below on what your favorite set of the week is. If you would like your sets to be featured in one of those videos, please be sure to post them in the Top Plays channel, and that will probably be your best bet. I will be going over the replays posted there on a bi-weekly basis and try to evaluate them to the best of my abilities. Until next time, Admin Crow here, signing off. Goodbye, technicians!